Hey everyone, this is a quick look at the LEGO City Jungle Halftrack Mission Set. Most of the Halftrack builds that LEGO has produced have been in their original IP and non-realistic themes like Ninjago and Chima. So to me, it feels like a little bit of a treat to get a semi-realistic one, you know, with just a basic truck kind of platform. You can see this being a coach built thing, or maybe even just a straight up conversion with the Halftrack axles being added on. I think it looks pretty cool. I appreciate the forward rake. You know, it makes it look like it was a conversion indeed. It was a lifted up, heavy duty pickup truck. Still retains a lot of its original flavor, but adds in that really distinctive look with the treads. The treads do feature a cheater wheel on the base. The rubber wheel, or rubber wheels, on the sides, on the forward axle, to get more traction, because these are hard plastic treads and those rubber tires are hooked up to make this thing actually turn, even if you're going on a hard surface. If those weren't there, then it would tend to just kind of slide around, and that looks weird. Also, another thing that looks weird is the inclusion of those blue parts there. I guess they're not that bad. I guess they're intended to stand out, but yeah, just a little thing. Plenty of room on the back to put stuff. It has a chain here that you can connect up to things. Kind of use that as a tow hitch if you want to. Clip over on the side, well, clip on either side, hold on to minifig accessories. And that roof piece is, it's an old part that's been used on trains a lot, going back to at least the 90s. But this is the first time it's been produced in this nice bright orangish yellow, or yellowish orange color, I believe. Didn't actually look it up. It's the first time I've ever seen it in that color. They've kind of got fake doors on the sides with stickers. That's a little bit of a disappointment. I think they could have given us you know, just actual regular doors there. But the interior is pretty simple. Just has a space. I was going to say a seat, but not actually a physical seat. Just a space for a single figure centered with a steering wheel in front. They call this thing an ATV. It looks a little bit more like a truck to me, but you know, a name is just a name. What's most interesting about this to me is that it's so much smaller than the Halftrack in the same set, and yet it pretty much does the exact same stuff, all the exact same stuff. It holds one person in the driving compartment, and it is able to carry cargo. Now, the Halftrack can carry more cargo, but not a whole lot more. I mean, you get a couple of studs of extra space behind there, but you probably put this on sideways and put a couple of these on there as well. And this also has the bar on the back that can be used to attach that same chain that's on the Halftrack, so it can tow things just the same. It looks like it's an off-roader. Looks like they designed it to have independent, or to represent independent, suspension in the front. Yeah, this is just a more efficient build. I don't think it's the greatest looking thing. I definitely think the Halftrack itself looks better and looks more complete, but as just a little side build, to be so close to competing with the main one for utility and play value, that's just interesting. Now, this crate back here is cool because it's in gray. Usually those are in brown, and it comes with a bunch of stuff. Got the metal detector there, a pan, just, you know, stuff for preparing food, like this piece of poultry, and a camera back here. This big cat, you can call it a Black Panther if you want to be nice and general. You can call it a melanistic leopard or a melanistic jaguar. Doesn't really matter. It can be whatever you want it to be. It just looks cool. If you're following the types of animals that are included in this series, they do have a tiger, which would suggest that this is a melanistic leopard. However, all the ruins distinctly look like they come from ancient South American finds, which would mean it would have to be a jaguar. But again, it can be whatever you want it to be. It's all good. Has the same articulation as all the animals of this size from LEGO, with the ability to move the head up and down by the neck joint, and also has the merged rear, rear legs that allow it to stand up like this, so it looks like it wants to climb up a tree or is interested in something that's above it. So here is this set's example of those distinctly South American styled ruins. This is another nice looking thing. Has a little bit of the natural terrain, a little bit of the man-made stuff put together. Very simple creation of a face kind of style, and it has a pretty respectable action feature as well. It's simple, but I like it. I'm actually going to use the quote unquote ATV to hook up a chain to this thing to try to pull out a whole tray of treasures inside of there, since I see that gem there. Of course, a minifig could probably just walk right in and just grab it, but what they want you to do is hook up a chain to this thing, right? And then pull against it and activate the booby trap, which brings this spider out. Here's the same thing from a different angle. You just pull on that and it just lifts everything up. Again, with some exposed or exposable weird colors back here. It's a cool feature. It works well, but this whole build definitely does not look good from the back to me personally. Between these two figures, I find the one on the right to be far more interesting. She has a distinctive face with a distinctive set of eyebrows that really stand out. And she has that hairpiece, which is not too old, and here it is molded in dark brown. Just always good to get more variety of parts in general from LEGO, but the prints on the torsos look good to me, front and back. I also think I like the print of the one on the right better than the one on the left. I like the inclusion of the canteen there especially. But this figure on the right is a gift that keeps on giving because she has this secondary face, which is also very useful and distinct. Oop, almost forgot to show you this. Just a little campfire that's also included. The things I like best in this set are the cat, the female figure, especially her head and hairpiece, and the front of the jungle ruins build, but not the back of it so much. Things I dislike include the redundancy of the two vehicles, especially how inefficient this one is with its use of parts, and the price. Just does not honestly seem like a good value to me at its retail price. I think once this goes on clearance or goes on sale, something like that, then it can be interesting, especially to be able to get that half track, efficient build or not, certainly to get the cat, but just overall, by default, regular prices, I just don't see the value here. That's my story and I'm sticking to it, but please feel free to share your own story of what you think about this set if you have a moment. Respectful feedback is always appreciated by me and other viewers as well. So thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.